In this video, I'm going to talk about how you can get started with AWS. So many people are learning AWS today because it's a really growing industry. There's lots of job opportunities and it's exciting technology as well to work with. So you're in the right place and we've got everything you need to get started. All right, so what should you do? One of the first things to think about is where you are in your journey and your knowledge of IT and cloud, and use that to work out where to start. So for example, let's say you have no background in technology at all, you don't know about the cloud, then of course you need to start kind of at a foundational level right at the beginning. So we have lots of video courses to help you there. For instance, our Introduction to Cloud Computing course. Now, most people want to earn certifications so they can demonstrate to employers the expertise that they have. Now, the starting place there is the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner. That's a great starting point for anyone coming into AWS, and it's especially important to start at that level if you are new to the cloud. After that, you can then go on to the associate level. It's the next level up, and there's three different certifications. The most popular is the Solutions Architect Associate. Then there's the Developer Associate and the SysOps Administrator Associate. I recommend you start with the Solutions Architect Associate first, and then you might want to think about going on to the other ones. So you need to understand where to start. If you have some background in technology, you can start at the associate level. If you don't, then I would start at the foundational level. And in fact, I recommend everyone who's doing certifications on AWS starts with a cloud practitioner first. So next, what are the resources available to you? Well, we have video-based training, we have practice tests, we have cheat sheets. All of that is available on our website. So you can find the relevant training course to go in and watch the videos, learn, practice with us. So you'll have lots of opportunities to build things on AWS as you go through the training, and use the practice test to practice your skills and make sure that you're learning how to answer questions and preparing for the exam. We also have challenge labs, which are hosted by Skillable. The challenge labs are AWS sandbox environments where a certain challenge has been set up for you, and you have to complete the exercise according to the instructions. And in some cases, you get scored based on how you did as well. Now, another learning option is our bootcamps. The boot camps are where we actually have live training as well as the on-demand training. So you work with other students and instructors in a live classroom environment, and you get to do a lot more hands-on training. It's a really great way to build your practical skill set. From a timing perspective, you can earn some certifications in as little as a few weeks. For others, it might take multiple months. And again, it depends on how much time you have each day to study and where you're starting from in terms of your expertise and knowledge. So for example, I would recommend at least a month to 2 months for the cloud practitioner if you're new to IT. And for the Solutions Architect Associate, you might be looking at 2 to 3 or 4 months even to pass that certification exam. And the more time you dedicate, then obviously the faster you can do it. Now, the exams themselves cost $100 at the cloud practitioner level and $150 at the associate level, and they get more expensive for the professional level and the specialties. The good news is that after you pass one exam, you get a voucher for 50% off the next exam, so it does bring down the cost quite a bit. Now, people often ask, will I be able to get a job with a certification? Now, yes, it does definitely help you to get a job, but of course there are other aspects to getting a job as well. Now, I would recommend that you make sure you get at least 2 certifications, the Cloud Practitioner and the Solutions Architect Associate at a minimum if you're going for an entry-level job in cloud. You may also need some other skills, for example, Linux and Python as a programming language, not 100% essential, but very useful skills for those who are applying for cloud jobs. Now, please check out our Getting Started with AWS webpage. There's lots more information there. There's lots of free resources, and we've got links to our paid resources as well so that you can access all this training, get certified, and hopefully land a job in this industry. So I wish you all the best and have fun learning AWS.